The revenue of TCS was $27 billion in 2022. Wipro made over $10 billion in 2022. A friend of mine who runs a production agency made over 4 crores every single month in the last year. A friend of mine who helps companies grow on LinkedIn makes over 10 lakhs every single month. What do you think is common between all of these? They are all service-based companies. Hi everyone, I'm Ishan Sharma, and with me today I have my co-founder Saransh Anand from MarketUp. And today I want to talk about how can you start a service-based agency from scratch, right? Hi Saransh, how are you doing there?
Hello everyone, it is great to be back on this channel. And as Ishan said, we'll be discussing 5 steps today through which you can make your own agency and make crores every year.
Yeah, that is a bit far-fetched, but you can get started, and overall, with time, you can reach that milestone. But we will be sharing our own experiences of how we grew MarketUp to over 1 crore every single year revenue, and I hope that will help you out. Let's get started. Hit the like button. And the first step that you need to understand is, even before you start agencies, understand agency hota kya hai, right? So agency is essentially a group of people who work together to accomplish a deliverable for a client, right? Let's talk about what type of agencies are there out there, right? So first of all, ek hoti hai aapki Facebook ads wali agency, jo aapke Facebook ads run karti hai for a lot of companies, right? Secondly, hoti hai aapki company jo ki ek digital marketing solutions provide karti hai, jaise koi ek social media campaign run karna hai ya fir koi particular content create karna hai. So these agencies help companies with that. Another one can be an email marketing agency, जिसमें वो newsletters या फिर emails को optimize कर रहे हैं उनको send करने में. So these are some examples of agencies that you can get started with. There are a lot more that you can do. Sky is the limit. There's also something called as influencer marketing agency. You should check out this podcast with Ayush Shukla if you have not already about the same. But these are the types of agencies. अब बात कर लेते हैं about how do you get started. As Saransh mentioned, we'll be talking about 5-step process that you can take from scratch to build your agency. The first one that I want to highlight has to be to find a niche and to pick up a skill, right? When you are just getting started, you don't need to worry about all of those crazy numbers, all of the people that you'll be hiring. You just need to focus on what market you want to cater to and what skill do you want to acquire, right? Even before an agency, you need to focus on the skill. I started out with editing videos. I started out with learning about design and how it basically works. I edited videos for a lot of clients, and then slowly I transitioned into offering more services and starting my own agency, which is MarketUp. Right, Saransh, what was your experience with learning skills?
As I've said pichle kai podcast mein bhi ki, I started with creation of memes. So it is also one of the agencies that you missed out on. Meme creation is also something that you can do in your agency. When I was in 11th standard, I started creating memes, and that was one of the skills that I acquired in the very beginning. Following that, I learned about SEO, I learned about blogging, I learned about affiliate marketing, and dheere dheere karke I realized that Instagram marketing was something that I liked. In general, creation of posts, for example, is something that I like. So yeah, that is how I figured out that, okay, this is something that I wanna double down on. And jab humne MarketUp start kiya, to fir we decided ki, अच्छा ठीक है, यूट्यूब की सर्विसेज से हम लोग शुरू करते हैं. मे बी वी कैन लेटर ऑन स्केल टू इंस्टाग्राम, लिंक्डइन, इवन ट्विटर सर्विसेज फॉर दैट मैटर.
राइट, सो दैट इज हाउ यू नीड टू पिक अ स्किल. नाउ व्हेन यू आर पिकिंग अ स्किल, ऑलवेज रिमेंबर, फाइंड आउट योर TAM, योर TAM, राइट? एज इन एनी स्टार्टअप पिच डेक यू माइट हैव सीन, TAM क्या होता है? टोटल एड्रेसेबल मार्केट. तो हु आर द नंबर ऑफ पीपल हु वुड वॉन्ट योर स्किल? How important is that skill to them, and how replaceable is that skill to them as well, right? So you realize all of that. There can be UX design, you're helping companies build UX for their companies, website, it could be an app as well. Secondly, you're helping companies run ads for them. So you're focusing on how can you master Facebook ads, how can you master Google ads. The third thing can be you're helping companies with content, right? So it could be written posts on LinkedIn, it could also be editing for Instagram Reels to get the company viral traction on the platforms. Next up can also be email marketing through newsletters and other things. So you have to define that skill, and you have to understand ki kitne logon ko chahiye ye skill. So that is the first step that you need to master. The second one, what is the second one, Saransh?
So second step that you need to consider when you are starting your agency is packaging. Now, आपने अपने skills define कर लिए that okay, these are the kind of offerings that I can have, but it need to make sense to the client as well, right? So MarketUp जैसे YouTube की services offer करता है, so we go to the client and we don't say कि आप जितने videos दोगे हम उतने ही edit करके channel पे upload कर देंगे या हम लोग उतने के management कर लेंगे. The way it works is that we go to the client, we tell them that, okay, this is the minimum commitment that I expect from you, right? Which I 8 videos ho gaye ya 4 podcast ho gaye. That is how it works. And then we tell them that, okay, this is the pricing that we can go ahead with. So this is something that you need to do in order to make sure that what you're offering is required in the market, right? So agar aap video editing services provide kar rahe ho, to fir you can probably classify them through 3 different categories. One can be short, one can be podcast, one can be explainer videos. Or animation videos for that matter. So you need to make sure that you package your offerings depending on how the market is. Maybe you can also take a look at how the other agencies are selling this product and take some inspiration from that.
Right. So what you need to understand in packaging is that, as Saransh mentioned, as a video editor, you can create different packages, and instead of just editing one video, getting paid for that, you build a whole retainer package. Ki bhai, I will be editing 5 shorts for you, 1 long form video and maybe 1 podcast for an example. And you sell that package, right? You say ki agar aapko ek reel ka main 1000 charge kar raha hu, 5 reel ka maybe I'll charge you 4500. You give a discount to them, but you're also creating a retainer income for you, right? So aap sirf ek freelancer nahi ho ab, you are thinking as a business and you are creating recurrent income for you, right? So you have to understand this is the power of packaging. So for example, with MarketUp, I knew video editing. Saransh was interested into SEO and he knew about Instagram and how social media platforms work. So we grouped together that and we offered a whole YouTube management service, right? Iske andar video editing bhi hogi, uske andar thumbnails bhi honge, usme SEO bhi hoga, usme pura ek analysis bhi hoga YouTube channel ka. So that is essentially what we had offered. Ye ho gaya packaging. The third thing that you need to master is going to be the sales, right? That has to be the outreach. Theek hai, you made a portfolio, you made your skill, you defined your niche, and you also created a package. Ki acha main aise bechunga. Next step is, who is listening? Who is watching? How can you reach out to them? Ab sales hoti hai do tarah ki, right? You have inbound and you have outbound. I'll talk about inbound first and then we can go over the outbound from Saransh. Inbound mein kya hota hai? You need to first make a name for yourself, right? You need to get discoverable. Bahut sare jo log hai, right? Freelancers jo hai, they are essentially zombies on the internet, right? They are just lurking around. Bahut sare log ke content dekhte rehte hain. And they're just wondering. Bahut sare logon ko apply karte rehte hain. Is job mein maine apply kar diya. Maine is freelancing gig ke niche apni request dal di ki haan, I can help you complete your project. But usme kya hota hai ki they are never able to get projects. Kyunki they are just grooming around. But people don't have trust on them. To say ki chalo theek hai ye banda kar lega out of the 10 others who have applied. So the first thing is to get discoverable, right? So if you're a designer, you need to be on Behance, on Dribbble, on Instagram. You need to show your work, right? You need to have a proof of work. Aapne ek portfolio to bana liya, but aapko use dikhana hai logon ko, right? So that could be in the form of you sharing designs on Twitter. It could be in the form of sharing it on LinkedIn. It could also be making content about what is happening in the world out there, right? So you do that. The best example is of Anik, who is a friend of mine, who is a designer. Go check out his Instagram if you want to learn more about what he does. That content that he's creating helps him get reach on other platforms, and it also helps him get clients for his own agency, right? So that is a great thing that you can get started with to build your personal brand and get inbound leads, right? People see your post and they reach out to you. Recently, we uploaded a case study of a client that we worked with on Twitter as well as LinkedIn. And as soon as we did that, we got a ton of traction from people saying that, yaar, I want to explore your services. At least there was interest. Why? Because I put my experience out there and maine list down kiya ki kaise humne is channel ko grow karne mein help kari YouTube par. And that is the best thing you can do when you are getting started, when you don't have a lot of leverage. So that was all about inbound sales. Ab baat karte hain about outbound sales from Saransh.
So inbound sales mein jaisa Ishan ne bataya ki company aapko reach out karti hai. Now outbound sales mein ye hota hai ki aap company ko reach out karte hain and aap unko batate hain ki main XYZ services offer karta hun. So for example, pichle step mein jaise humne packaging kari ki okay, chalo aap agar YouTube ki services provide kar rahe hain to aap YouTube mein video editing provide kar rahe hain, manage प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं, स्ट्रैटेजी प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं. अब आप जाकर के कंपनी को रीच आउट करेंगे और आप बताएंगे कि अच्छा ये चीजें मैं प्रोवाइड करता हूं. नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज कि आप कैसे डिटरमाइन करेंगे कि आप कौन सी कंपनी को रीच आउट करोगे एंड उनको रीच आउट कैसे करोगे? द आंसर टू द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज आप एक डेटाबेस क्रिएट करेंगे जहाँ पे बहुत सारी कंपनीज का इन्फॉर्मेशन होगा. नाउ फॉर एग्जांपल आपने डिसाइड किया कि मैं फिनटेक कंपनीज को रीच आउट कर रहा हूँ, तो आप फिनटेक में जाकर के सर्च करेंगे कि कौन सी कंपनीज को अभी रिसेंटली फंडिंग मिली है. फॉर एग्जांपल फंडिंग न्यूज़ के लिए आप योर स्टोरी पर जाकर के देख सकते हैं कि अच्छा कौन सी कंपनीज को फंडिंग मिली है. क्रंचबेस पे जा सकते हैं. आपको इसके बाद एक शीट क्रिएट कर लेनी है जहाँ पे सारी कंपनीज का आपने इन्फॉर्मेशन डाल दिया. अब इन कंपनीज में आपको ये डिसाइड करना है कि आपको किस पर्सन को रीच आउट करना है. तो आप लिंक्डइन पर जाओगे उस कंपनी के पेज में एंड आप देखोगे कि एम्प्लॉयज़ कौन कौन है एंड उसके हिसाब से आप डिसाइड करेंगे कि आप किसको रीच आउट करना चाहते हैं. तो अगर कोई छोटी कंपनी है फॉर एग्जांपल, तो फिर आप को फाउंडर को रीच आउट कर सकते हो या फाउंडर्स ऑफिस को रीच आउट कर सकते हो. बट अगर कोई बड़ी कंपनी है तो फिर आप मार्केटिंग के किसी प्रोफेशनल को रीच आउट कर सकते हो जो उस कंपनी में ऑलरेडी काम कर रहे हैं. अब क्वेश्चन ये आता है कि आप उस एम्प्लॉय को कहाँ पर रीच आउट कर सकते हो. तो लिंक्डइन इज डेफिनेटली एन ऑप्शन, बट कई लोग लिंक्डइन पर एक्टिव नहीं होते हैं, तो फिर आप उनको ईमेल कर सकते हो. ईमेल ढूंढने के लिए यू कैन गो टू hunter.io. तो फिर अगर आप हंटर पे जाकर के कंपनी का यूआरएल डालेंगे तो फिर आपको एक फॉर्मेट मिल जाएगा ईमेल का. तो उस फॉर्मेट के अकॉर्डिंग यू कैन गेस कि इस एम्प्लॉय का ईमेल आईडी ये होगा. एंड व्हेन यू रीच आउट टू देम यू नीड टू मेक श्योर दैट यू ट्राई टू इंप्रेस देम विद योर वर्क. सो फॉर एग्जांपल अगर आप यूट्यूब की सर्विसेज प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं तो फिर आप उनके यूट्यूब पे जाएंगे, एक बार चैनल को ऑडिट करेंगे व्हाट आर द मिस्टेक्स दैट दे आर मेकिंग एंड उसके हिसाब से आप बताएंगे कि ये चीजें मैं फिक्स कर सकता हूँ आपके चैनल पे अगर आपने मुझको हायर किया. नाउ द अदर ऑप्शन इज दैट यू रीच आउट टू अ लॉट ऑफ ब्रांड्स. तो इस केस में आपने जब डायरेक्टरी बना ली तो फिर यू विल हैव टू डू समथिंग कॉल्ड एबी टेस्टिंग. एबी टेस्टिंग में आप मल्टीपल कॉपीज लिखेंगे ईमेल की. फॉर एग्जांपल मैंने दो ड्राफ्ट्स बना लिए ए और बी एंड मैंने आधे लोगों को ए भेज दिया एंड आधे लोगों को बी भेज दिया. नाउ डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द रिस्पॉन्स आई विल डिसाइड कि अच्छा मेरे लिए ए बेटर वर्क कर रहा है एंड आगे जाकर के मैं सबको सिर्फ ए भेजूंगा. नाउ एबी टेस्टिंग इज नॉट जस्ट लिमिटेड टू ईमेल, बट आप लिंक्डइन पे रीच आउट करते हुए भी यही सेम प्रोसेस फॉलो कर सकते हैं. ईमेल और लिंक्डइन के अलावा आपके पास क्या ऑप्शंस है? तो आप इंस्टाग्राम या लिंक्डइन पे रीच आउट कर सकते हो लोगों को मैसेज करके कि मैं ये सर्विसेज प्रोवाइड करता हूँ एंड आई कैन हेल्प यू. या फिर आप फेसबुक ग्रुप्स पे जो लोग रिक्वायरमेंट्स डालते हैं उनको रीच आउट कर सकते हो, उनको बता सकते हो कि मैं ये सर्विसेज ऑफर कर रहा हूँ.
अच्छा एक चीज जो आप कर सकते हो दैट विल मेक श्योर कि ज्यादा लोग आपको रिप्लाई करें व्हेन यू आर रीचिंग आउट टू देम थ्रू आउटबाउंड सेल्स इज दैट यू शो योर एफर्ट, राइट? सो व्हेन यू आर रीचिंग आउट टू सम कंपनी, लेट्स से कि आप यूएक्स डिजाइन ऑफर करते हो सर्विसेज, यू रीच आउट टू देम सेइंग कि भाई आई एनालाइज योर वेबसाइट एंड मेरे को ये चार चीजें लगी दैट आई कैन हेल्प यू इंप्रूव एंड इससे आपका जो लैंडिंग पेज कन्वर्जन रेट है वो इतना इंप्रूव हो सकता है. Let's just say that you help people with YouTube, जिसे हम लोग करते हैं. You can talk about a few things that you can improve on their YouTube channel and how that will help them grow on YouTube. So depending on the services that you offer, it is very important to show the intent and write down how can you help them get better results through their social media handles or through their website. So that was about inbound and outbound sales. This is the third thing that you should be mastering. The fourth one is going to be managing your finances and operations. राइट अब आप लोगों को लगेगा कि ये तो क्या ही इंपॉर्टेंट चीज़ है, बट लेट मी टेल यू व्हाई दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट. राइट व्हेन यू ट्राइंग टू हैव अ बिजनेस, राइट, यू आर ट्राइंग टू हायर पीपल, यू ट्राइंग टू स्केल, राइट, इन दैट स्टेज इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू स्टे एफिशिएंट, राइट. यू नीड टू डिप्लॉय प्रोसेसेस सो दैट एवरीथिंग दैट यू नीड टू गेट डन फॉर द क्लाइंट एंड द डिलीवरेबल्स गेट डन एफिशिएंटली, राइट. सो व्हेन यू आर क्रिएटिंग दीज प्रोसेसेस इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू कीप अ फ्यू थिंग्स इन माइंड दैट वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग राइट नाउ. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इवन बिफोर यू गेट स्टार्टेड लेट्स जस्ट से दैट यू टॉक टू द क्लाइंट इज इंटरेस्टेड, यू से दैट यू विल बी चार्जिंग एक्स अमाउंट फॉर योर सर्विस, दे से दैट इट्स कूल, लेट्स वर्क, लेट्स गो टू द नेक्स्ट स्टेप. Then you share a agreement to them, right? You don't just say ki theek hai, okay, I'll start working with you. You create an agreement jiske andar everything is defined, right? The scope of work, ki aap kya kya kaam kar rahe hoge, the deliverable, the expectations that they should be having and what expectations you have from the client. Let's just say ki we offer video editing and YouTube growth. Uske liye video create karna padega client ko and if they will not create the video, then you cannot edit the video, you cannot grow the channel. So you need to have a clear expectation from the client and from the freelancer or the agency owner. And the next step for you is going to be, once the agreement is signed, is to create an onboarding process for them. जब वो आपके साथ काम करने में आ रहे हैं, what all things you would need to ask them to make sure that you can create a great experience for them, right? That is the second step that you need to master. Okay, now let's talk about the operations. You've onboarded the client, what do you do next, Saransh?
सो वैन यू टॉक अबाउट ऑपरेशंस यू हैव टू मेक श्योर कि आप ये डिसाइड कर ले कि कहाँ पे सब कुछ मैनेज हो रहा है, राइट. तो यू कैन स्टार्ट विद नोशन फॉर एग्जाम्पल, जहाँ पे आपने चीज़ें असाइन कर दी. तो फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर ईशान का काम है कि वो मेरे को वीडियो हैंड ओवर करे, तो फिर आई विल राइट कि ठीक है, ईशान इज सपोज टू हैंड ओवर द वीडियो टू मी ऑन एक्स वाई जी डेट एंड उस डेट पे जाकर के मैं देखूंगा नोशन पे कि मेरे को वो वीडियो आ गई है. वंस आई रिसीव द वीडियो आई स्टार्ट एडिटिंग, आई स्टार्ट वर्किंग ऑन द वीडियो एंड मैं वहां पे अपडेट करूंगा दैट यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट द आउटपुट टू बी रेडी इन 2 डेज फॉर एग्जाम्पल. एंड 2 दिन बाद ईशान आकर के चेक कर सकता है कि वो वीडियो एडिट हुई है या नहीं हुई है. एंड आई नीड टू मेक श्योर दैट आई अपलोड द लिंक ऑन नोशन सो दैट सारी चीजें एक ही जगह पे मैनेज हो पाए. अब आपने एग्रीमेंट तो बना लिया बट यू नीड टू मेक श्योर दैट यू आर गेटिंग द पेमेंट्स एट द राइट टाइम. तो उसके लिए आप इनवॉइसेस को ऑटोमेट कर सकते हैं. सो फॉर क्रिएटिंग द इनवॉइस यू कैन यूज समथिंग लाइक रेफरेंस, जहां पे जाकर के आप एक रेकरिंग इनवॉइस क्रिएट करेंगे जिसकी वजह से मंथली बेसिस पे सेम डेट को क्लाइंट को वो इनवॉइस चली जाएगी. एंड वहां पे आप इंस्ट्रक्शन प्रोवाइड कर सकते हैं कि अगर 5th को इनवॉइस गई है तो यू नीड टू मेक द पेमेंट बाय 15th ऑफ द सेम मंथ. सो आप 15th को जाकर के ये चेक कर सकते हैं कि वो इनवॉइस पे हुए हैं या नहीं हुए हैं. अदर देन दैट यू नीड टू मेंटेन अ बुक, जहां पे जाकर के आप सारी पेमेंट के लॉग्स देख सकते हैं, नॉट जस्ट द रिसीवेबल्स जो चीजें जो अमाउंट्स आपको आए हैं बट जो आपने खर्चे किए हैं वो भी. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल आपने कोई सॉफ्टवेयर खरीदा तो फिर यू नीड टू मेक श्योर कि आप उसका एक्सपेंस भी उस बुक में मेंशन करें सो दैट महीने के एंड में आप ये डिटरमाइन कर पाए कि आपने टोटल प्रॉफिट कितना कमाया.
I think this is a very important thing. I recently met Sarthak Ahuja as well and he was telling me how creating a simple book of all of the balances ki kya aapne kis cheez pe spend kiya, kahan se aapko paisa aaya is very important and aapko wahin se pata chal jayega ki aap kahan kitna effort laga rahe ho aur aapko kitna ROI mil raha hai from any client or from any software for that matter as well. So that is a very important thing to do.
I think this will also help you identify ki aap kahan kahan pe inefficient hai. For example aapne koi software khareed rakha hai jisko aap use nahi kar rahe ho but uske payments katte ja rahe hain to that is where you will identify ki okay mere ko is cheez ka subscription cancel karna hai.
So that was about managing the agreement side, finances, the invoicing along with the operations. ये सारी चीज़ें बहुत important हैं. बहुत सारे लोग इस पर focus नहीं करते हैं. इस वजह से बहुत सारी जो agencies हैं इंडिया में they are just not efficient, right? They are just a combination of tons of people who don't know how to communicate, who don't set the right expectations, as a result of which the work does not get delivered on time. Moving on to the last step that you need to master, and that is hiring people. So what happens is when you are building an agency, right, you are working yourself, right? We are assuming that aap sab kuch kaam khud kar rahe ho. Aapne sales bhi kiya, inbound kiya, outbound kiya. Aap khud hi apna portfolio bana rahe ho, khud hi skills seekh rahe ho, sab kuch khud kar rahe ho. There will come a time, and I hope it does for you, that you just don't have time outside of the work that you're doing right now. Aapke paas 2-3 client hain, unhone aapko khub sara kaam de rakha hai, aap khub sara kaam kar rahe ho, paise kama rahe ho. And that is when you should think about creating an agency jisme aap logon ko hire kar sakte ho, right? So the next step for you is to start hiring people so that you can delegate tasks. Now this again is a very huge topic. How can you delegate tasks so that you can focus on higher ROI activities? Jaise mere liye in marketup it is much better for me to get a client that will create more ROI than for me to edit a video for a client particularly. And that is what you need to understand. As you scale, your time becomes a lot more valuable. So what you need to learn is how can you delegate tasks and focus on higher ROI activities. Now, when you're thinking of hiring people, do tarah se kar sakte ho. Either you can hire vertically or you can hire horizontally, right? Ye bahut hi important cheez hai for you to understand. In an agency, aise maine bataya, starting when you need to find a skill. Let's just say that you picked video editing. You can hire vertically, जिसके अंदर आप और video editors को add करते जा रहे हो and you are just offering even more videos edited for the clients that you are working with, right? तो पहले आप खुद बैठ करके let's say आप महीने में 15 वीडियो कर पाते थे एडिट. नाउ यू कैन मे बी एडिट 40 वीडियोज फॉर द क्लाइंट बाई हायरिंग 2 more people और 1 more people. नाउ एट दिस स्टेज द सेकेंड थिंग यू कैन ऑल्सो ट्राई आउट इज हायरिंग horizontally. इसमें क्या होता है, यू हैव अ स्किल ऑफ वीडियो एडिटिंग बट यू ऑल्सो हैव अ फ्रेंड और यू नो समवन हु कैन ऑफर थंबनेल्स और यू नो समवन हु कैन ऑफर पेड एड्स, राइट? सो दे आर इनटू एडवर्टाइजिंग, यूट्यूब एडवर्टाइजिंग या फिर फेसबुक एडवर्टाइजिंग, वट एवर इट इज. सो यू बोथ टीम अप टुगेदर एंड यू से दैट यू विल बी ऑफरिंग दिस बंडल्ड पैकेज ऑफ एडिटिंग वीडियोज एज वेल एज प्रमोटिंग द वीडियोज, राइट? एंड यू स्टार्ट पिचिंग दिस टू अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल. Now, in both of the cases, you need to find who is the right person to work with, right? बहुत सारे लोग आपको मिलेंगे in your experience that would want to work with you because उनको पैसा दिख रहा है आपके पास, right? कि ये बंदा 1 lakh rupees per month कमा रहा है, 2 lakh, 3 lakh कमा रहा है, I want to work with him. Now, there are 2 types of people that you can find to hire, right? There is person number 1 who is skilled at what they're trying to do, be it video editing, graphic design, UX design, whatever you're looking for. But that person might just want to work for you for their portfolio. So they come, they work with you, and then they'll just leave, very quickly. Now, when you have a person like that, you are investing your own bandwidth to work with them, to help them with their own craft, to help them build their portfolio, and they suddenly just leave you. Now, the second type of person is one who actually values the teamwork, right? They want to be with you, not just for the money angle, but also for the learnings that they will have when they are working with you, right? When you work with people, when you work with clients, when you create that experience, you get to learn a lot of new things. How to talk to new people? How do you pitch a particular service? Whenever a particular client does not pay, what do you do after that, right? So all of these things are very important, and that one person who actually values the whole experience, that is your ideal candidate to work with, right? So that is essentially what you need to look out for. Ab ise kaise pata karte hain, that is a very tricky thing. Mereko abhi tak nahi pata hai. There are so many people who I've worked with. They come, they work with me, then they just leave. Feels like a hookup to me. But I think that it's very important to keep looking for people who would value you and that position that you're giving to them. And they would give their all, their 100% to create the best work possible and learn through that journey, right? So always find those people who can delay that money angle, right? That type of person is going to be very important for the company and the growth that you will have as an agency. So that is how you hire people, right? So these were the 5-step process that you can take to build an agency of yourself and offer services to your clients. I hope this video made sense to you. If you have any questions around how can you start an agency, let me know below in the comment section. And now let's finally quickly summarize, how do you start an agency in 5 steps? Saransh.
So video ka saransh ye hai ki aap sabse pehle decide karenge ki aapko kaun si skill pasand aayi, fir aap decide karenge ki aapko usko kaise package karna hai, fir aap usko logo ke samne bechne ki koshish karenge. Jab aapne bechna shuru kar diya, aapke paas paise aane lag gaye, agla sardard hai paise. पैसों को आप कैसे मैनेज करेंगे, फाइनेंशियल्स को कैसे मैनेज करेंगे, ऑपरेशंस कैसे मैनेज करेंगे टू मेक श्योर कि सब कुछ सही हो रहा है. एंड जब ये सारी चीज़ें आपने फिगर आउट कर ली, तब आप डिसाइड करेंगे कि अब इसी सेम मॉडल को मैं रेप्लीकेट और स्केल कैसे कर सकता हूँ. सो दैट इज बेसिकली द 5 steps दैट यू नीड टू फॉलो टू बिल्ड योर एजेंसी एंड स्केल इट टू प्रॉब्ली 7 digits.
ऑलराइट, दैट वॉज द वीडियो. आई होप यू लाइक्ड, आई होप यू लर्न समथिंग फ्रॉम दिस. मेक श्योर दैट यू शेयर दिस वीडियो विद अ फ्रेंड. साथ में स्टार्ट करो एजेंसी, ग्रो करो, एंड आई होप दैट यू बिकम सक्सेसफुल इन योर जर्नी. आई विल सी यू ऑल इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. And if you want to tag us on social, and if you want to share a learning that you had from this video, you can tag us at ishansharma7390 and saransh.xd. And I will see you all in the next video. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.